Hey everyone, it is your girl, Boss Lady Lexi, coming in with a live video, you all. Now I'm trying to figure out if I need this light or not, so bear with me, y'all. This is just what you call some technical difficulties. So let me see. If it gets too dark, I'll turn the lights back on. But I want y'all to see this gorgeous purple backdrop. I'm sitting in a different location in my room. How are you all doing? As you can see, I got little pigtails in my hair today because today is like kind of housework day. And as y'all know, housework for us women and men never ends for us that do it. Hey, Valerie Jones, how are you feeling today? How are you? Can you hear me okay? I'm talking with my headphones on. Let me move a little bit closer. Hey, Jalen, how are you? Thank you all for coming in. I see we have 6 people watching, 4 people thumbs up this video. We're getting there. Let me know, my head's cut off now. So, as you all know, before I get started with any live stream, I always pray before the live stream. I have started that trend. Pray before you go live. And so far, so good since I have been praying before I go live. Hey, Herman the Great, how are you? Welcome to this live stream. As you all come into my home, my channel, I just ask that you hit that thumbs up button, because it just brings joy to my soul and to my heart when I notice that y'all be smashing that thumbs up button. Also, if you are not subscribed to my channel, please make sure that you hit that red button, hit that bell right next to it to be notified of every time that I upload videos, and that way you become one a part of the Little Bosses Squad. The Little Bosses Squad here are just some phenomenal people. I mean phenomenal. I can't say anything else more about them. They are phenomenal. They are great. They are optimistic. They are awesome. They are beautiful people, vibrant people, and I just love them. And I'm going to go back into the comments. Let me turn my big old trusty iPad on, because y'all know it's so big. But anywho, while that is warming up and everything, let's just go ahead and get this prayer going. We got 7 people watching, and before I pray, is there any prayer requests? Before I pray, are there any prayer requests? Hey, it's me, the Browns family. How are you? Welcome over to my live stream. Welcome to being a part of the Little Bosses Squad. Today is Tuesday, and for those that are cooking, it is Taco Tuesday. Hey! And I didn't put on no makeup because I don't know who puts on makeup to do housework. I'm just washing the stuff that's on my bed. About to sit here. We'll talk to you all while I fold these clothes of little nuggets and all of that good stuff. And I need to go just put another load in the washing machine real quick. So other than that, I'm not doing anything. I was just seeing if there were any prayer requests. Hey, Tamika Chaplin, how are you? Welcome to the Little Bosses Squad. Hey, Joe Alice, welcome. Welcome, everybody. I thank you all for thumbsing up this video. I just give God praise, honor, and glory. Please pray for peace, love, joy, health, and happiness for all. Amen. Alrighty, we're going to go ahead and get into this prayer. Father God, we come before you right now in the name of Jesus, Father. And Lord, as I always say, we come to say thank you, Lord. Lord, thank you for waking us up this day, Father God. Lord, thank you for giving us the air to breathe, Father God. Lord, Father God, we come before you on the altar of prayer, Father, asking for peace, love, joy, happiness, wealth, Father God, healing in the name of Jesus for everybody, Father God. Lord, Father God, there are so many people that are sick and shut in, Father God, and they just don't have an outlet and they don't know what to do, Father God. But Lord, Father God, I place them on the altar right now, Father God. Lord, Father God, for healing in their body, Father God, from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet, Father God. Lord, for those that are mourning, Father God, Lord God, I just pray that you would comfort them, Father God. Hold them in your arms, Father God, and rock them, Father God. Let them know that you are there, Father God. Lord, Father God, give them peace, Father God. Just speak to them, Father God. Just speak to them, Father God. Lord, let some nice songs, Father God, or scriptures in the Bible just come to their heart, Father God. Lord, so that they will know, Father God, that you are there, Father God, as a comforter, Father God. Because in your word, Father God, it says weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning, Father God. So, Lord, Father God, I pray for joy for all of those that are going through, Father God. Lord God, a good friend of mine is going through, Father God. And not just her, we all are. We all love this young lady who has passed on, Father God. But we know she said yes, Jesus. We know she said yes, Jesus. But, Lord, I pray that you would comfort the family, Father God. Lord, be with them, Father God. Help them, Father God. Lord God, because it is a sad time, but we know that she is up in heaven rejoicing, Father God. And Lord God, I just pray right now for everyone that is in this live stream, everyone that is coming to this live stream, Father God. Lord God, I just pray for whatever it is that they need, Father God. Lord, Father God, be with them, Father God. Lord, if it's healing with anxiety, Father God, touch them, Lord Jesus. Lord, Father God, if it's they need help with their bills, Lord, Father God, send the right people their way, Father God. Send them the right information, Father God, so that they can get help. And Lord, Father God, as I go through this stream, Lord God, I bind every demon, every devil in the name of Jesus. I put them under my feet, Father God. And Lord, Father God, I thank you, Father God, for everything. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen, amen. How are you all doing today? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. What have you all been up to? I know that was a long prayer, but I just had to get it in because you just never, ever know what people are going through. You know what I'm saying? Hey, MZK baby, did you get your package? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Look, I had to sit here and think. Amen, amen, amen. And you know, I try to come live when Little Nugget is asleep, but I think he just woke up. So Alexis is just going to have to get him for a little bit if he starts, you know, going over there carrying on, because he don't have no clothes on. So how is everyone doing today? In case you missed it. Oh, this was all yesterday's stuff. Okay, I see we have 11 people watching. Let me turn down this volume because y'all know I can't see. I can't see for anything. So let me get that up. And let's go on over here to the live chat. And let's see what y'all talking about. Okay, we have Valerie Jones in the house. Herman the Great. Jalen Sharp. Shalira's Love. Hey, Lexi, I haven't seen you. This is the first time I'm seeing you over here. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. Hey, it's me. I can't even get your name out, girl. Hey, Ingra. Hey, Miss Brown. Hey, Tamika. Hey, Joe Alice. Oh, hey, Shamita Williams. Lord, Shamita Williams just asked for prayer for her boys, Father God. I'm not sure if they're in school, Father God, right now, but I just pray and ask that you will cover them afresh with your blood, Father God, while they're in school, that no hurt, harm, or danger will come, not just upon her kids, Father God, but anyone's kids that are in school right now. I just pray and ask that you would just be with them all in the name of Jesus. Amen. MZK Baby is in here. DC Kool-Aid. Hey, hey, Maya. Hey, Frank GTV. Yes, the devil is so busy, but we have got to bind him. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Everyone is speaking to everybody, which is great and loving. Can y'all just hold on 1 second? Alexa! Come here, please. See, I can't never have a live stream without this little boy being in here, but he ain't got no clothes on. And you know, it's a lot of pedophiles out here, so we got to put this little onesie on him. Can you put that onesie on him and put that stuff in the washing machine? I'll keep him. I'll keep him. And put the fan on low, that's all. Hey, twins been acting up behavior-wise. School starts Monday. Oh, no. You know what? Shamita. And his pacifier is in his car seat. Let me tell you something. And I don't have any boys, but I know how Christopher is. You know, when he would be acting up and showing out, I would just talk to him, you know? And I would just tell him, hey, this is your home. I am the adult. You are the child. You are going to listen to what goes on in this house. And these are my rules, not your rules. So you have to abide by my rules because guess what? You are a child. And as a child, you have to listen. So, you know, you may have to take something away from them until they get it right. And then, you know, you let them know, hey, I had to take this from you until you learn that, hey, you cannot do this kind of behavior here in my home. And once they get their act together, you give it back. That's the only advice.
Relax.
Hey, DC Kool-Aid. Hey. Okay, DC Kool-Aid, I was thinking about something, about a collab. Now that my lights are up, I got lights, y'all. I got lights. I was thinking y'all can come on over here and we do a nice collab together, play some games, family against family. Let me know, girl. Hey, Mike. Oh, this is Malaya and Nathan's Adventures. Hey, boss lady, how are you? Beautiful grandbaby. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, while she's doing that, let me just get the folding, y'all, because still waiting on her to bring this basket in here.
I'm trying to organize my closet because my pants were too heavy for my racks.
Oh, it was?
Yeah, so I have to switch something out of my closet for the pants.
Oh, okay.
I have too many clothes. I need another one.
Oh, okay. I understand. You give me a date. You let me know. Whatever date is good for you is good for us. We can do, like, you let me know. We can do the Skittles challenge against families.
We
would
win again.
I have another one with the Chex Mix. You have to get whoever can get the most of whatever we choose. We can eat some mumbo wings. Girl, we gonna get it on and popping over here in this camp.
I can make some cookies.
Alexa says she can make some cookies.
I make the best cookies
because
I'm the only one.
Look at you, folks. Yes, I am folding the baby's clothes. Y'all, I done already been to the... Let me tell y'all. It is so hard to remember to put this little camera up when I'm walking down that long hallway to the laundry room. We can wash the clothes here in my apartment, but I have to take them down the hall to the laundry room. So I forgot, and I've been going back and forth to that laundry room a lot, and my left knee is hurting tremendously, but I forgot, y'all, to record. And yesterday I went 4 times, so that, I guess that just doesn't count because, I didn't record it. So, but I did work out and I've been working out today, just changing my bed, walking around this house, washing clothes. Now I'm folding clothes. Now I got to put another load in the washing machine. So crazy. Me and my hubby got paint, so I know how hard it is for housework. Yes, housework is time consuming, you know, and it puts a lot on you. Hey, Metro Sonic, welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. Y'all, I'm recording on my phone, so if it says unavailable, that's all. I'm just hanging up on. I'm just hanging up on folks. That's all. That's all. Just hanging up on some folks. Y'all, baby Nugget is something else. Let me tell y'all about him. He will throw up, and his little hoarding self will try to keep it in his mouth and swallow it. So we've got to hurry up and catch him. It's raining like cats with a massive thunderstorm cloud. I could get out and grab some lunch. Oh, no. But you know what? It just said on the radio that it was gonna rain and storm here again today, and it's like the sun will be out. And the storm, what TV?
You said the radio.
I meant the television. She always corrected me. She get on my nerves. And it says that it's about to storm again. I'm hoping not, because people need to get home from work. You taking them with you?
Absolutely not.
That sounded so wrong.
Yeah, it did. Y'all, wait a minute, because his throw-up game is on point. And before y'all say these were stolen out the hospital, you can buy these on this website called Baby... it's one of them reborn doll things, Cheryl. I can't get it. Hey, say hi, everybody. Say hi. I be trying to do vlogs without you. You know that? I be trying. Because that's what it... It's not about you, little boy. They looking at you. Hello?
He's looking at the wall.
Yo, he is so fascinated with that wall. There you go. They're looking at you. Say hi. Say hi, everybody.
Oh, I made it into the car seat.
The car seat is over there.
No, this one.
Why are you bringing that?
Because the pacifier landed in here.
The car seat is right there with the pacifier.
Yeah.
Say hey. I don't want the car seat. I just want the pacifier.
Pacifier.
It's in the car seat. Yeah. That underneath your eye. Yeah. So, let me know what y'all are doing today. And can you put those clothes in the washing machine?
I started
please?
Organizing my pants.
Okay, thank you. There you go. There you go. So, let me go and see what's going on here in the chat. Hey, Taurus Local Inspiration. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Little Nugget, everybody is saying hello to you. Hey. No, he don't. He's not really a... He only likes the pacifier when he is extremely, extremely fussy. I mean, really, really fussy. It's back there. That's the phone right there. That's if he's like really, really fussy. At work, gotta go home and clean my kitchen and do laundry. Yeah, we have to clean up today too and rearrange some things because Terminex is coming tomorrow. I don't play with little brownies, y'all. I don't play. That's not your phone right there?
Where?
Oh, I guess you didn't bring it in here.
No, I did.
I don't play. It was on the couch. I don't play with little brownies at all. So Terminex will be here tomorrow in between 12 and 5. So, I do not play, y'all. I can't stand them little things. And saying I don't like them either. I don't care. I told the man one was one too many, okay? He was like, we can come tomorrow. I said, today is even better. Gotta go away. Hello, baby. Hey, Metrosonic Tara. Frank G says hi. Hey, Fee Felicia Ann. How are you? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. I really don't know what to do, but I did just come on live to sit here and fold clothes and talk to y'all. But it seems like, and I was going to try to sing some songs while I fold, because y'all know I did that before. But somebody has said that they wanted to make an entrance. I guess that little nap wasn't good. I guess she wasn't milk wasted. See, y'all, look. Say, I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I'm 10 weeks old now. He's a big boy. Uh-oh, I heard it. I hear it. I hear it. Yeah, you need a good one today. Yeah. Hey, Erica Land, how are you today? Welcome, welcome, welcome. School starts for Alexis on September the 4th. So she has, I told y'all it was coming. Oh, let's back you up. Let's back you up. No, don't touch. No touch. No touch. Whew. I don't think they want to see this. Y'all, his throw-up game is serious. I mean, serious. Ugh. I got it, though. Yeah. See, I got it before it started to spread. And these big little things come in handy because you can just fold it up. Yeah. Uh-huh. You talking? Y'all, he talking to y'all. Ah! I knocked it down. And don't you kick the little bosses over now. I just folded inside and put him back because I'm quite sure some more is going to come up. Ugh. Now, let me see what y'all talking about. Oh, thank you, Erica Lynn. She said he's so adorable. Tamika says, hey, Frank, how are you? Hey, Metro's Malsonic says, was past plan for the week. I decided to make a quick and post that yesterday, draw and voice over with a great impression. Oh, I have to come over and hear that. Frank said he's good, Tamika. It's the Brown family says hello to everybody. Hey, Happy Lux. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. Oh, they sure do grow fast. Yes, they do, Metrosonic. Tamika Chaplin says, that's good, Frank. Metrosonic says school is already in session here in Oklahoma. I see the school is in session in a lot of places. But since we're no longer in Fairfax County, they'll start the week before Labor Day, but here in Alexandria City, they start the week after. So these kids had 2.5 months out of school, and I think that's enough. Hey, Miss Brown and family from Frank G. School is my hometown. Chicago will be in session till September. Oh, they won't go back until September. So, you know, we really got to pray for our kids, y'all, every day before they leave up out of the house. You have got to cover your kids afresh with the blood because these streets are crazy. Not only the streets, but some of these students, I'm not going to say that the students are crazy, but I'll say that a lot of the students are misguided. And we have got to, you know, really, really keep them under the blood. Because it was too many school shootings last year. Again, one was too many. There should not have been any, you know. And I'm just praying that this school season that none will happen to nobody's kids. That the bullying and everything will stop. You know, that they will have so many counselors, you know, all over the schools that, you know, these children can have some place to talk to. They can go somewhere and talk to them because it's not easy. It's not easy at all. Do you want to sit in your chair? No, don't knock that over. Y'all look. Them hands. You see yourself? Where did you work at today? Where? Tell me where you worked. Because that was a big boy yarn. Like, you've been tired and you put in a whole 8 hours and maybe 2 hours of overtime. Y'all, he is so fascinated with them hands. Y'all, I'm glad your little chair is right here. So let's move some of this stuff around. Put that right there. And we got your little chair right here. Your little swing. Let's put this right here. Yeah. Because, say, Granny Lexi got things to do. Yes, she do. Oh, there you go. Can you what?
Throw that in the trash.
Throw what in the trash?
That.
No, she's going to hang it up.
But it's collecting lint.
It's okay. You just take something and wipe it off. I need the clothes basket, please.
I'm not done.
Oh, you can't swing. I'm so sorry. I apologize. Let's move this over. Oh, I don't have one. There you go. All right, y'all. That takes care of him right there. We got him all set. He is in his swing. And I think I need to close this door. I'm good, I think. I told this girl to put the fan on low, and she done turned it off. But it's okay. I can feel that little breeze. Yes, y'all. These little things right here, they come in handy, y'all. Because his throw-up game is woo-wee. It's terrible. It is absolutely terrible. And we are constantly, you know, having to wash them. As you can see, some of them have been bleached and, you know, so much. I'm trying to figure out what's the name of that website. Bountiful Babies. That's the name of it. I knew I was going to think of it. It's called Bountiful Babies. If you have babies and you need these receiving blankets, that's what the website is called, Bountiful Babies. Oh, a little sock fell. Try to get it up. Y'all, Shamira is making this Alexis Hello teriyaki stir fry. I may record it tonight. Hey, Jeanette Pickering, how are you? Welcome to the live stream. Yes, Tamika Chaplin, he act like he's so sleepy. Yes, he does. He act like he is so sleepy. And he ain't did nothing but sleep all day. Sleep, eat, and poop. That's it. Eat, sleep, and poop. I'm very good, thank you. That's good. Yes, she may. Oh my gosh, I'm going to film it. And I'm going to try and help her be in this video while she's doing it. And we have this wok, y'all. It is. It seemed like as soon as you put the stuff in there, it's done, you know? And I've been trying to upload this video of this mukbang that I've done, a seafood mukbang. But, yo, every time I go to try to get it together, something always happening. So I'm going to try to upload that once I'm done with this live stream because it was a really good thing. But I have a question. For y'all that do the seafood mukbangs, hey, Rowdy Chica, how are you today? My question is, are the crab legs supposed to be salty? These crab legs was extremely salty. And I'm not quite sure why they were so salty, y'all. I really don't know why. And the way people eat them, I'm like, and I told Shamira, I think their water was just very, very salty when they steamed them. And they needed to clean their water because they was, even she was saying they were salty. But she was eating her blue crabs, y'all. I ate one for y'all on the live, I mean on the video, but y'all can't see all of me. Y'all, let me tell y'all. Y'all, this is my door. Let me close. Y'all, it takes so much to eat a blue crab. For that little bitty teeny meat, it takes a lot of work. I mean, a lot of work just to get some meat out those things. That's why I told Shamira, I can't fool with them. She was like, you want another one? I was like, no, I'll stick with what I had. But I didn't even eat all of what I had because I got full, but I got some shrimp that's in the refrigerator right now. I think I'm going to make some shrimp salad with it because I haven't eaten all day. So I am going to do an upload on Aretha Franklin today. Did she pass away, G. Franklin? G. Franklin. Frank, did she pass away? I know she was gravely ill. I've never had blue crabs. I used to eat them when I was a child. Oh, okay. Man, I love me some Aretha Franklin. What you want? Baby, I got it. What you need? You know I've got it. All I'm asking is for a little respect. Just a little bit. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Find out what it means to me. Y'all, that was my song growing up. I used to love listening to Aretha Franklin and Mahalia Jackson. Woo, chat. Now that was some, definitely, that was some epic singing back then in the day. But at least you could go and find some of that music on YouTube and really listen to it. Because sometimes, I'm telling y'all, it's them songs that get you through. Other than prayer, it's them songs that get it, that will get you through. I'm telling you, it will uplift your spirit. It'll get you to like, hey, oh, hey. I'm telling you, it will do it. So don't sleep on the oldies but goodies. Oh, she's home with family. That's good, because first they were saying that she was in the hospital. Y'all, this is so cute. Mommy's little man. Oh, Lord, you done thrown up again, little boy. Come here. Let me get it. There you go. Wasn't a lot. There you go. No, but from what I see on YouTube, I'm not missing much with the blue crabs. No meat. I like the snow crabs and the king crabs. Yes, Tamika, I totally agree with you with that one. Then I was going to try the Dungeness crab. I have some king crab legs from in that haul. I didn't eat those when we was eating the other crabs because I just want to eat them by themselves with maybe some shrimp because my stomach, I had gastric bypass surgery a long, long time ago. And my stomach still acts up every now and again. But y'all, when I ate them crab legs Friday night, I was like, oh my gosh, not again. Every time I eat them things now, that they make me throw up. TMI. I know that was probably just a little bit of too much information, but it makes me throw up. Metrosonic says, I'm 27 years old, Erica. Wait a minute, I'm missing some of these comments, y'all. I apologize. She says she's home with family. Come on, stay still. She's home with, she still does need prayer, Frank. Oh, there we go. Yeah, she still needs prayer. Hey, Gangsta Mama, thank you for coming in. Thank you for thumbsing up the video. Hey, Valerie Jones is saying hey to Erica. Gangsta Mama is saying hey to everyone in the chat. Everyone, let's make Gangsta Mama feel welcome. Let's make her feel welcome. I see we have 19 thumbs up and 14 watching. That is so awesome, y'all. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I really appreciate that. Valerie Jones is saying, hey, I mean, Erica Land is saying hey to Valerie Jones. Yes, that's what I like to see. I like when y'all interact with each other. I want to talk about a little bit today. When I watch people's content videos, or when people just watch my content videos, I really love to comment back to you all. Because it's like I'm holding some kind of communication with you all. Phone Jones says, hey, Lexi, how are you? Thanks for the gifts. Oh, you're more than welcome. You're more than welcome. I hope you love them. I was searching through my stash, you know, and I was like, I had to try to put your personality with my merch. So I hope you love everything. I hope everything fits okay. And happy belated birthday to you. I know I was late getting it out to you, girl, but you know how boss lady Lexi is. She's still the boss, and she has got to support her little bosses, the ones that are always there for her and check you. Because Phone Jones, she checked me, honey. She checked me on a situation, and you know what I did? I received that check. I did not have any animosity or anything from her. I received it and I kept it in my heart. And I was like, that's something that I learned from to never, ever do again. And honey, let me tell you. Some of these folks, like I tell y'all, that is here, some of my little bosses, they may be young, but they are wise. And they will put you in your place and, you know, keep it going. So I thank God for that, because sometimes Boss Lady Lexi do needs to be checked by her little bosses. She do need to be put in her place. So I thank you for that. I ain't mad. I received it, and I guess what? And I kept right on going. And I am still a great supporter, because I sure enough didn't know who no PJ and SG was. I was like, wait a minute, who are these people that know about me? They know a lot about me, but I don't know nothing about them. And here was that Phone Jones and her hubby SG. I did not even put the two and two together. Isn't that crazy? But I told y'all, I'd be on the slow bus sometimes. So, you know, when you on that slow bus, Phone Jones said, I just want to keep it positive because things can turn crazy and folks love mess. You are so right, Phone Jones. I appreciate it. But you know what? You put me in my place. I received it, because you know what? Like the Bible says, sometimes you've got to be put in your place, because if you don't know, you're not going to know. You have to be chastised sometimes. And some people don't like when they're chastised. But I don't mind being chastised, because you know what? That lets me know that I'm a bigger person to accept what somebody else is saying to me. You know, that's just how I am. And that's how a lot of people should be. You should be able to, you know, talk it out with one another and, you know, just nip it in the bud. You know what I'm saying? Phone Jones is saying, hey, gangster mama. Phone Jones is saying, hey to Frank. Metro Sonic says, I will catch you later. I need to make a phone call. Thank you so much for coming in, Phone Jones. Metro Sonic. Gangsta Mom is saying hello. Joe Alice Tate is saying hi to Gangsta Mom. Y'all, this is another cute one. But I'm going to get some hashtag 1 pound at a time on some of his baby clothes. I can't wait. I just have to go to my little favorite spot to get them done. Hey, Leilani's Kitchen. How are you? Now, let me see about Leilani's Kitchen, y'all. Y'all need to check her out. She was eating some stuff yesterday. Girl, let me tell you, Leilani's Kitchen. Welcome to Taco Tuesday, first of all. Phone Jones is saying, hey, Leilani's Kitchen. Y'all, if you have never, ever watched the reviews of Leilani's Kitchen, you need to watch them, because her and her kids give some honest reviews, okay? She was tasting the Pringles. It was like something spicy. No, chili. Some by Pringles and Lay's. And y'all, I don't mean no harm. Pringles has been out for a very, very long time. But Pringles now have some competition now. They got some competition going on. And their competition is with Lay's. Shamita said, I want some turkey wings in a crock pot. Oh my gosh, they are so tender and good. I've also learned a new tip. Replace the water with chicken stock. Girl, yes. Yes, you ain't said nothing but a word. You ain't said nothing but a word. I think I was watching Smoke the Boss. I know I'm probably saying his name wrong, but I'm always commenting. Smokehouse Boss or something to that effect. And I believe it was him who cooked some in the crock pot. And oh my gosh, y'all. I'm telling y'all, got to watch these channels, honey, because they are, you just never know what you can learn from these channels. But I was watching Leilani yesterday, her and her girls do their review on the Pringles and the Lay's. And I have to say, y'all, Pringles might as well give it up. Because Lay's chips are more seasoned to me, and they are more thicker in taste than them little thin things. But Lay's has got to get it together and stop having all them crumbs in the bottom of the can. Y'all need to figure out a way how to get them potato chips inside that can without them crumbling up. Even though we know once we put them in our mouths, we're going to chew them up and they're going to get crumbled. But hey, they got to figure it out. Hey, Leilani's Kitchen, hoping you feel better soon, love. Leilani says, back is killing me, but I'm good. Hey, girl. Hey, PJ. Hey, Phone Jones. Hey, Joelis. Hey, Frank and everybody. Yes, I'm both smoke. Yes, see, y'all be knowing who I'm talking about. Yes. But she's going to make this teriyaki stuff her way. She made it before with chicken and shrimp. But I told her the only thing where there was a problem was the broccoli. It cooked too fast, so it was like mushy. I said it just need to have like just a little teeny crunch in it. But it was so good. Sounds good. Teriyaki. Hey, Gangsta Mom from Leilani's Kitchen. Yes. 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 Y'all see how he is such a good baby? He loves this little Fisher-Price swing. He loves his Fisher-Price bed. Y'all, all you do is turn that music on and he is in heaven. Gangsta Mom is doing the wave sign back to everybody. Y'all, this is one of his blankets that I really love. And he loves it too because it's so soft. Yeah, it is so soft. Hey, the Native family. How are you? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. Thank you so much for coming in. Thank you, thank you, thanks. Thank you. Hey, Gangsta Mom, I'm not sure if I've asked you this before, but can you tell us just a little bit what your channel is about? And also, if anybody wants to write in the chat what their channel is about, it'll definitely be appreciated, you know? Because some people don't know. Hey, Red's Barbecue and Pizzeria, what about when you reach out to the end of... What about when you reach the end of the Pringles and the tip of it and they're all gone in your mouth? You know what? But that's telling you that them Pringles were so good and you stick your hand back in there and they're all gone. come on, Rance, with that one. Yes, I definitely know how you feel. I'd be like, dang, they all gone. Leilani's Kitchen said her channel is about food and family. And yes, it is. MZK Baby is here. Hey, MZK Baby, did you get your package? Because what I do is I put the P.O. box from the sender and to the other person because I don't have a P.O. box yet. Gangsta Mama says, I really don't know right now. Maybe cooking, cleaning, and story time and mukbangs. What is that? Stuff for the Goodwill? Huh. Let me see.
Come on, I just struggle to get this box open.
Girl, you better not give Shamira dress away.
I already gave two of them away.
Shamira, look.
She can't fit it.
Okay, y'all. Alexis is giving this dress away. So if you pay for the shipping, it's yours, it's clean. Here's another one.
I did not want to auction off my clothes.
Y'all, look at these pretty sundresses. It's summertime. This is a maxi dress.
And I'm maxi short.
Yeah, she is a little short, but this one would look cute on you.
No, I didn't like it. My boobs were too big.
Oh, you said your boobs was too big? Let me look. Honey, we got some subscribers here that may like this.
Why did I bring this in here?
MZK Baby, this would look cute on Jada. P.S. This is going 30 minutes now. Halloween Google. What? PJ's channel is my hubby's and our channel. And oh, PJ Jones is saying that PJ and SG's channel is about her and her hubby. But they do random stuff. The Native family says, PJ, I'm going to love 30 minutes in Halloween goodies. MZK Baby said, what size?
It's an extra large.
It's an extra large 15-17. The other dresses, I believe, are, I remember this dress. This dress is so pretty.
No, it's not.
I just saw Shamira wear it. This dress here is, a size 2X. I forgot to tell y'all what the sizes were. And everybody is wearing these little cute things right here. This one is a one size fit all, and this one came from Florida. So, yes, this is so cute. I wish they had them in, you know, big people sizes like my size. I love these kind of dresses. They just like you throw them on and you just keep on going.
Well, you already showing them all the dresses.
Shut up. This is a size 16, 18, MZK, baby. I do. You wore it you wore it to church, I think, one time. All right, let me see what she's saying.
No, you have to fold them.
Girl, boo.
It was folded when you took it out.
I know, but you can fold it back, please. I'm going to fold this one for you, though, because I really like this one. I've been trying to find this on Amazon in my size. Those are so cute, and they, Lexi, could you also sell? Oh, she's saying these could sell on Poshmark. Oh, thank you, P. And I have a Poshmark. I don't have nothing on them. Put them over there. I'm going to take some pictures.
A prom dress?
Okay, just sit that over there.
I don't like it. It was Corey's.
Oh, Lord, y'all. I'm too embarrassed to even show this, but I'm just going to.
It's so ugly.
I'm going to go ahead on and show it. Y'all, this is a prom dress. I mean, it's probably cute for somebody. I like the bottom of it.
No, it looks like a praise dancer's outfit.
That's what it looks like. It looks like a praise dancer's outfit. Exactly. Yes, I can put these on Poshmart and make a couple of dollars. Sell
Excuse
them for.
Excuse you, I can make.
No, a you just said give them to the Goodwill. Y'all, didn't she just say give them to the Goodwill? Yes, she can fit all but the first one. Yes, but on Poshmart. Okay, you see, now we talk about money, because you know, when you give it to the Goodwill sells your stuff, and they keep the money. So, thank you, Phone Jones. I'm going to take some pictures now. I'm going to hang them right up on this door on a hanger.
We're selling them.
Oh, no, you just said giving them.
We get 50%.
No, you get, how about no percent? You
I
just you just gave them to me.
No, I did it. I gave them to the Goodwill.
The Goodwill was going to sell them and give you nothing.
Okay, but we can also sell some of my shirts, too.
Y'all, she is too funny. Phone Jones said, hey, DC Kool-Aid, put that box over in that corner. Hey, what you eating your hands? Wait a minute, what time did I feed him?
What time is it?
Oh, I don't know. Somebody know what time it is? Oh, wait a minute.
You
I got you.
Right,
it's 5:14. I fed him at 3, y'all. He's on clockwork, honey. Can you fix that bottle over there for me, please?
Tell me that.
I did. And I didn't tell you. I asked. Did you start the washing machine yet?
I just got finished organizing my pants. I needed some fingers.
Oh, my Lord, child. You so slow.
Where do you think them dresses came from?
Y'all, she says she just got finished organizing her closet. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and feed you, little y'all. This thing right here is a love.
Terrible.
This thing right here is a love-hate relationship right here.
She doesn't like it.
I don't know why. I
why
do not
did
like
you
this.
Do all of that?
But I brought it. I brought this from in New Jersey, y'all. It's just a love-hate relationship. I don't know. It's just something about it, y'all. I don't know what it's about. Exactly, Leilani's kitchen. Now she want money after she done said, give it to the Goodwill. She is something else, y'all. Oh, y'all, I'm like little nugget. Let me turn this light on, because it seems like we need a little bit of. A little bit of light over here. There we go. Had to get a little bit of. Hey there, my little snookum tickatums. How are you? Your mommy will be home soon saying hello.
Hello to you.
Hello to you. Hello to my baby. Y'all, we hear this about 15,000 times a day. That we now, and then she's going to say, so what did you do today? Tell me, you didn't call me today, y'all. It is too hilarious. Do you hear me?
And then in the morning, she'd be like, I'll be right back.
Then when she leaves in the morning, MZK baby said, hey, little nugget, I don't think she got to see you. Oh. Say hi. Say hi, everybody. Say hello. Y'all, his little cry face be so serious, like, please feed me. Please feed me. But she making the bottle. She's getting it together. Yes. Oh, they said all to you, little nugget. Yeah, it is horrible. It is horrible. If you have ever tasted that Similac baby formula, oh, it is the worst. Oh, oh my God. I can't even tell y'all. It just made my stomach turn just thinking about it. All that mess tastes nasty. None of it is good. And the crazy part is they love it. These babies, I guess that's all their palate knows, so they just sit there and say, we're just going to take it, and we're going to just eat it, and we're going to drink it. Hand them to me, please.
You should have been quicker than that.
Now, let me not call y'all Dr. Miracles. Dr. Browns, these are a lifesaver. Do you hear me? These are a lifesaver. I mean, he still throws up with these bottles, but the milk does stay in his mouth. Them other ones, the milk would be just everywhere. So I really, really love these. That's what he said. Them clothes could have been finished washing by now. That was earlier before I even started washing clothes. I still ain't got my clothes basket.
You have milk in your neck.
Then get a baby wipe and wipe it out. Look at his little feet. Y'all, he is truly a chocolate drop. Do y'all hear me? He is truly a chocolate drop. See, I'm going to get his neck size, 6 to 9, wait a minute. Yeah, the neck size is 3 to 6 months. And I'm going to have hashtag 1 pound at a time going across the front of them.
Are you going to take him or not?
Wait a minute, I'm trying to read the comments. Leilani says, him's not happy. She said, feed that baby. Yep, I breastfed, but my babies went to a sitter. I pumped and used the Dr. Brown's bottles. Oh, you had a phone call? Yeah, Shamira did have milk. She just decided not to breastfeed. She said it felt like she was still pregnant because she couldn't drink no alcohol.
She could.
I used Agents and Tommy. Oh, we have those Tommy bottles, too. The Tommy bottles are good, but she uses those at night because she gives him formula at night. Because his little sleeping problems has gotten a lot better. And with his throw-up game, the cereal helps him better at night so that he's not, throwing up the whole night. Oh, he looked like he's in the spotlight on the red carpet.
So his eyes look black in this light.
Because he got my eyes.
No, he doesn't. He has mine.
Girl, boo.
Look at these gorgeous. Feed the child.
Well, you ain't hand them over. You the one over there playing with them. Y'all, let me tell y'all. The hardest thing is to let this baby go. Because once he get into your arms, you got to fight to get him back. You know? They just be fighting. But Shamira, aggressive self, she just comes and tries to snatch it. You gotta like hold him like this and protect him. Because you don't want to give him away. Where's his little, I'll just get a new one. Come on.
Oh, am I your is it all the way over here? I know the people next door is probably about to complain.
Say, it's feeding time. It's feeding time. Say hi, everybody. My name is Little Nugget. My name is Little Nugget. My name is Little Nugget. Say hey, 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 hey. Little Nugget is my name. Little Nugget is my name. Say hey, hey. Hit that red button for Little. Stop. Hit that red button for Boss Lady Lexi. That's my Lexi Granny. Yay, that's my little Lexi Granny. That's my Granny Lexi. Yes, she is. She's the best grandmommy in the whole wide world. Yes, she is. Yes, she is. I love Granny Lexi so much. And when I get to walking, I'm going to Granny Lexi's room. Hey. Say hey, my little bosses. Say hi. Say hi. Say, this how my Granny Lexi say it. It is your girl, Boss Lady Lexi, coming in with another live video of me. Hey, it's me, Little Nugget. Yay! Okay. I gotta go now. I gotta eat. You gonna show them how you kick your legs? Kick them. You gonna show them? Kick them. Okay. Ooh, y'all, he heavy. Okay, don't kick the clothes now. Let's not kick them clothes because it took me a long time to fold them. But we can feed you, okay? We can feed. Oh, I'm about to say, if you don't want it, you don't have to take it right now. Yes, y'all. He loves this stuff. Well, he loves anything. Long as it's coming out of bottle, he loves anything. Shamira is like, I can't wait for us when he's able to eat food so we can share food. I'm like, okay, that's what's up. Yes. I know. You're so cute. You're so cute. You're so cute. Y'all, he is tearing this thing up. I know, MCK baby, right? Yes. Him so cute. Yes, him is. Yes. Y'all, he is just like, he only cry when he hungry. And God knows, you better have that bottle ready, honey. Because, honey, that trumpet gets the sounding. Woo-wee, y'all. He goes off. Wait a minute, how much more I got to fold? Oh, I only got one more thing to fold. Yeah. Then I have to, I think I'm going to be the one to take them to the laundry room, and then I'll have her bring them back from the laundry room. Or depending on how I feel like dragging this leg on down there and recording it, I might even do that because I didn't get in my exercise today. Other than, you know, in the house kind of stuff. Yeah, see, I'm glad I turned that on because the sun has gone down and it's starting to get... Y'all, I'm going to tell y'all why I haven't done my house tour yet. Because my kitchen, I cannot find... MCK Baby said he's going to be begging for like... Yes, yes, he's going to be sitting there... No, he might even just snatch it, MCK Baby. I don't think he's going to beg. He's just going to snatch it because his hands are humongous. Yeah, I just think you're just going to take it. Yeah, I think so. I haven't done the house tour yet because I'm still trying to find enough purple things to put into the kitchen. But I have been trying to find a purple dish pan. I can find them things in every color. So if my little bosses happen to find anything, could you send me a message of where you found it at in the item number or the link where it is? I've also been trying to look for some purple dish rags to put in the kitchen. I'm cooking, but I had to see Little Nugget, and I'm listening. Okay, Tamika Chaplin, thank you so much. Thank you for your participation and your encouragement and support. It really means a lot to me. I was going to just go away, do away with all my pots and pans, and just get purple ones. But I was like, I don't think that that's going to be a good thing. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Honey, being a grandmother is the best thing in the world. That's all I can tell y'all. It is the best thing in the world. Well, other than having your own children. But, say, with this one, you can give them back. You know what? You can call and say, okay, you can come pick up your child now. Where are you at? The club closed at 2 o'clock. Hey. Oh, thank you, MZK baby. And I don't really, like I told you, I really was never the type to put up like pictures and stuff like that. Caddy dish pan plasticware, wash basin, 14 ounce 3.
You got a burp pen.
I got it. I have the thing that you put the dish rack that you put the dishes in. I cannot find the purple thing which you put the spoons and the knives and stuff in the drawer. I can't find that. Or the dish pan that you put in the sink to wash the dishes. Or the wash rags, the hand towels that you use in the kitchen. I have looked everywhere, okay? I mean, I've been searching. I even went to this little store called the Purple Store online. And maybe I was blind Bartimaeus and I may have missed it, but I don't recall seeing it. But as you all know, purple is my favorite color, and I did want to have a purple kitchen. That's a dish pan I just posted from Amazon. You talking about the thing that you put the, can you send it to me on Twitter, in my Twitter message, and that way I can just go straight to the link? Because y'all, yesterday after we saw that a little brownie was on my dish rack, we had to take all the dishes off the rack and put them in the dishwasher. And I was like, oh no, I was on that phone with Terminex immediately. Immediately. Hey, KC Detox Diva, welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. I don't know how, and then they said, oh, we have to come to your building tomorrow anyway for somebody. Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Yes, y'all absolutely can come. You absolutely can come with bells on. Let's not knock the little bosses over. I threw a lot of stuff away. I threw a lot of stuff away, y'all. I am seriously decluttering a lot. Look, she gonna got the weights underneath this desk. Y'all, this is my double doors. My bedroom is, it's just so good. How you doing, Detox Diva? Y'all, look, I don't even know which one to even pull from. Y'all watch it now. You know the routine. You know I have to burp you. Okay, give me 1 second. I gotta just get a new little one of these. Y'all, he getting ready to act a fool. He is getting ready to show out. I know. I already know you're gonna do it. You was good for the little bosses and not show out. I try to burp him like every 2 ounces. Woo! That was a big boy burp. Yes! Okay. Okay. Let it out. Okay. Uh-oh. Got it. Before your little hand touch it. Let's get that. This stuff smells horrible. Horrible. Yeah. Thank you, Detox Diva. Okay, let that go. This is my hair. Let's get this last little bit of ounces in. Yeah, I'm trying to do that. And then I was thinking of, I threw my box spring away because it just wasn't acting right, y'all. It kept making my bed fall, but I think the guys didn't put it together the correct way. So I threw it away. So now I got to order another one. And my bed is sitting on the floor. So that's another reason why I haven't done the house thing. Because, you know, people, will they be coming for you in the comments, y'all. They be coming for you. Hey there, Ladybug. How are you? I'm doing well, KC Detox Diva. Let's see. Hey, Robin Neal. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. I used to bomb my apartment before I had it built. Let me tell you something. We found some bombs in the closet last night. So, y'all, I was going down to the laundry room. And you know how you can hear, like, somebody behind you? So, I know we have cameras, so I didn't feel like anybody was going to attack me or anything. But, you know, we still have those cameras on each end of the hallway. So, I'm like, well, if it is somebody behind me and they get ready to attack me, they don't realize they on camera. Y'all, I just happened to turn around. And guess who it was behind me? Shamira reading the box about the bombs. Y'all, I could not. And let me make that clear what kind of bombs it was. It was the bombs to bomb your house for bugs. The raid bomb stuff for they think we about to blow up something, y'all. Because y'all know. So you got to make it clear these days. But it was the raid bug bomb. But we was reading the instructions, and it was like, you got to leave the windows open, and you've got to be gone for 4 hours. And I was like, and then you got to clean up, like, the smoke residue from all the stuff from the bomb. I was like, oh, forget that. Terminex, I'm calling them first thing in the morning. And guess what? That's what I did. Because that's just something I do not play with. I grew up with roaches and mice, and I was like, whenever I get older and I get my own place, I'm not ever having no roaches and mice. That's just not happening. I sent you the links for the dishpan, the drawer organizer. Oh, thank you so much, Leilani's Kitchen. Shamita said, yep, I would set them off while I was at work. You can do a natural roach killer with borax water and sugar or honey, not the boric acid, but borax, the natural detergent. Terminex, it was $139 every 3 months. And he said within those 3 months, if, you know, you see anything, just call them and they will come right back out. They said that they will continue to come every time that you see something. He said, but you ain't going to have that happen with Terminex. I've had them before and we've never had to call them for anything. You can put that down after Terminex comes, and that would help for a long time because they take it back to their nest and it kills them. So where do you put it? Well, the baby's not crawling yet, so I think it would be safe to do it now. But once he starts crawling, if you have to, like, put it on the floors and stuff, I don't think that that would be safe. But let me tell y'all about Terminex, honey. They do your rooms, they do your bathroom, they do the window sills, they do under the counter. Like, these counters in our kitchen, they don't go to the floor. It's like space. So you can get under there and mop and do all of that and sweep and all of that good stuff. So he can spray up underneath of there. He said they do behind the refrigerator, the stove. They do everything. So wherever this little sucker came from, guess what? He getting ready to take his whole family some goodness because they about to be dismissed. She said, I'm okay, Casey. Back killing me, but I'm good. I know that feeling, Leilani. People don't understand. And I'm going to try to explain this as best I can. You know, when we... Oh, wait a minute. I'm going to come back to that because somebody was typing. Put it in a spray bottle and spray behind the refrigerator. Spray under the cabinets in the cracks, crevices, and creases. Wait a minute, y'all. I got to read from two different devices now. creases, but because it's natural, you don't have to worry about your plates and pots and pans. Oh, okay. Borax is not going to hurt humans. It hurts bugs. Oh, I've never even heard of that. But, you know, when we have been so heavy for all our lives and, you know, we start losing weight and stuff, our bodies are so used to us carrying that weight around, that when it's gone, we in trouble, because now we've done created some problems. Because when I was 455 pounds, y'all, I ain't never have an ache nor pain a day in my life. I was carrying that 455 pounds around like it was nothing. I was wearing heels and everything. And once I lost the weight, I was still wearing heels, but then it became a problem when they told me I fell in the yard and all of that stuff. And now all of these other things have done happened. And I just think that it all contributes to the weight. Like now that I'm moving around more and more and more and more and more, I still move slow as a daggone turtle and a snail, but I get to where I gotta go and I get to do what I have to do with the help of my kids. But you know, I just think it's just like our bodies are readjusting to not having all of that weight anymore. So it's like, okay, now what are we going to do now? You done lost all this weight. So now your body has to recondition itself to being thin and or smaller, as you can say. And it's just interesting. I'm like, man, this human body stuff is really, really something. Detox Eva says, my back is off the chain. I'm getting ready to break you. She says, I have multi-level spondylosis, my neck all the way down to my lower back, and it's causing numbness, and it pulls out my kink. You know what? I have spinal stenosis in my hands, in my neck. It radiates from my neck straight down to my hands. And y'all, let me tell y'all, that pain is, it is something. Oh, that was another big boy burp. Yeah, that was another big boy burp. Yes, good job. Good job. Oh, there it go. Come on, let it out. Let it out. Come on, drop. You got some more? Okay, let that little bit drop. Let that little bit drop. Yeah. I'm glad she didn't start that washing machine yet, because it's whites anyway, so this can get right on in there. Yeah, there you go. Don't start the washing machine yet. Okay, come get this stuff, please. See, y'all, it's a never-ending process, but it's okay. I have incurable disorder, so it's progressing for me. Leilani says, I have 2 slipped discs and a pinched nerve plus compressed discs in my neck and shoulders. Wow, mine's is, what did they say? I have something going on with the C4 and the C5. And I have, let me put a bib on you. And I have, that's where the spinal stenosis is. And I have something going on the L4 and the L5. So, you know, it's no easy stay. You hear me? But I just do as best I can. My daughter is my caretaker, my oldest daughter. And, you know, she helps a lot. I'm telling y'all, she helps a whole lot. And I'm just so appreciative that I have an older child that can help out. And don't mind helping, because she was like, well, Ma, you took care of us and you've been doing for us for years. So, you know, it's time for us to give back to you. And I just really appreciate and love that, because that is so true. That is so, so true. Let me see what's going on in the chat. Yo, this is so crazy. When this iPad is so different from the phone, you would think that it would stay the same. We're not old, would you? Yes, we the seasoned saints, y'all. Hey! Yes, we are definitely seasoned. Yes, y'all, I just be sitting here tripping out so much. You are still seeing pain management too. No, I don't have to see the pain management no more. They have already, they have already assessed me, and they said that I stay on the Percocet, number 10s, take two for pain when the pain is severely, really, really bad. But my primary care, she only writes a prescription for 30. I'm like, lady, why aren't you just writing the prescription for 60? So, you know, I just have to keep sending her an email through the Kaiser email system, letting her know. I get that rag off of the bed, those two off the bed. I thought you said you used it all.
No, I didn't think I oversprayed and overpowdered.
Oh. just add those two, three things right there. One, two, and three. Those, the Percocets make you loopy. Mine's went to 93. Woo! They don't make me loopy at all. Citibank. I think something is wrong with my body, y'all, because nothing really, like, when I tell people that I take gabapentin, not my pajamas, my pajama shirt. When I tell people that I take gabapentin, I have a malformation in which the skull is malformed, which causes spinal fluid, and it stops in my brain, and I have brain surgery about 7 years ago, so the spinal fluid wasn't flowing properly for 40 years. Oh, wow. Wow, KC Detox, we definitely gonna keep you in prayer, honey, because that's serious. That's some serious stuff right there. Oh, can't your pain management? Oh, I can't get pain managed because I don't qualify. I'm not on disability. You don't have to be on disability to get a pain management. They denied me saying that I was too young and I didn't bother to reapply. Girl, you better reapply because you're never too young for disability. Can you what? You're taking everything. Put that stuff in the wash, please. Girl, boo, she talking about she gonna have heat stroke. Sure don't.
In my room and record. It's hot in there.
Right. Let me tell y'all. I was just sitting at home one day and everybody kept telling me to apply for disability. I have to get Medicare instead of Medicaid, which they denied. Right. What you have to do is once you get Medicare, well, whichever one is through the state, I can't get them all, because I get them. Those are Shamira.
Is whiter than the other.
Whatever it is, you just go to your doctor and tell your doctor that you need to see pain management within their network. And once you get it within their network, that's... Yes. Once you get it through their network, then... You can get to see the pain management. That's how I did mine, through Kaiser Permanente, and that's how it worked for me. And I didn't have any problems. I went through my primary care, and with Kaiser, your primary care sends your referrals over right away, instantly. As soon as you say dog, cat, they have it. And then another thing is when I got my walker. Yes, ma'am.
But it has gray in it.
That's fine.
What is it?
It's not. I've done it before.
Okay.
When I was going through to get my walker, I called my primary care and I told her that I needed a walker. She said I had to go through physical therapy. So I had to be evaluated through them. I found a terrific plan, the doctor that accepts my insurance and literally goes to help. I know that's right, Shamita. Yes. I went to physical therapy. They assessed me, and the next day I was approved for the walker. Now, granted, did I really, really want that walker? No, I did not, because I thought people were going to judge me, which they probably do, but I don't give a rat's tail now because I've gained confidence. Hey, I've got confidence. Hey. I've got confidence, so I just take it out, and, You know, even my best friend RD, he was saying the other day, he was like, it really hurts my feelings to know that you have to walk with a walker just to get around. My primary care sent me to the pain management doctor that said he couldn't help me because I have a permanent issue and it's Medicaid didn't cover it. Oh, yes, they will.
Huh? Oh,
never mind. They will cover you. You just have to find somebody in the network to cover you, because Leilani, you should not have to live off of, Lord forgive me, but you should not have to live off of Tylenol and Advil and all those other things just to get the pain away, and it's not taking the pain away. God bless you. You
need to vacuum.
I know, I said I need to vacuum. You know, you've got to speak up for yourself. That's what I did. I'm allergic to every pain pill known to man, including morphine after brain surgery. I'm allergic to all inflammatory medications like Advil, all kinds of stuff. I'm just allergic to it. The only thing that works for me is, she's so silly. The only things that work for me and my body is Percocet, you know, those kind of things. I can't even think of the name of the medications, what they are. Controlled substances. That's the only thing that works for my body. That is the only thing that works. Exactly, Lexi. I have to take strong pain medicines. And yeah, I'm allergic to everything. Now, let me tell you.
Paul, you are not allergic to everything. You are not Alexis.
No, we're talking about medication-wise. When it comes, like when I go to the doctor and they see my chart, that's why they always come back with Dilaudid. I will. That's why they always come back with Dilaudid or morphine. What?
Why can she get outside out the window?
Girl. Y'all, I can't with her. Exactly. Oklahoma just passed medical marijuana, so I'm going to apply for that when it's up and running. Dilaudid is hydromorphine. It works. That's what they gave me when I was having them cramps in my side from me working out that time. The first time they gave it to me, y'all, I was trying to talk to y'all and keep my eyes open. But the second time they gave it to me, it took a little bit longer to get into my system. So I was like, mm-mm. But I'm going to tell y'all what's the real stuff. No, it's called, they gave it to Shamira when she was pregnant.
Ibuprofen?
Mm-mm. It starts with a D.
Dilaudid?
Mm-mm. It's not Dilaudid.
I
know, because we talk about them all the time. But y'all, that's the best medicine in the world. I'm telling you. They keep you in the hospital for about 4 or 5 hours. They're not going to let you go home until they see how your body is working. Demerol. That's what it's called. Y'all, Demerol, oh, you could be in all kinds of pain. Honey, they going to give you that Demerol, you ain't going to feel nothing. Nothing at all. Y'all, my back blew out. It stayed in my system for about a week. I couldn't go to work, y'all, for a whole week. Thank God I had some sick time. And it was workman's comp because it happened at work. Yeah, they do. No, they gave me, did they give it to me in my arm? Or did they give it to me? No. Are you right? I think they did. They either gave it to me in my arm or they gave it to me in an IV. But I told the lady, if you're going to give it to me in an IV, you're going to have to give me the medication to take by mouth for the nausea. Because, look at that. It doesn't affect me. It makes my stomach hurt so bad when they give me the medication for the nausea through the IV. I had that for my first son. Pain crazy man. Yes. So they gave me, and this really works for nausea, ondansetron. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but it's the generic is called Zofran, 4 milligrams. I take one because the Percocet used to make me nausea. Yeah, Zofran. I take one, put it under my tongue, and I don't have any problems with nausea or stomach pain. Or, and you know what, my little simple self should have took that Friday when my stomach was hurting from the snow crabs. I wasn't even thinking. I just took a Zofran. You get nauseated from the Zofran? That pill really works for nausea. It really, really works. What the matter? What the matter? You want to talk? You want to talk? No, I got dizzy, so I took one. Oh, okay. Yeah, that really works. Y'all, look what I tell y'all. And you see, I be keeping him still. It just comes right out. Those daggone pain patches. Yes. I have those pain patches too. Wait a minute. What are them pain patches called? I have a whole bunch of them, Shamita. I can't think of the name of them, but I have them. I went and brought some CBC oil the other day, and you all, I was high, so it was too funny, but it works. No, they don't work at all. No, they don't work at all. I can't even think of the name of. And this girl was telling me to get them for my knees because that's what she was taking. And, so sorry, I scared you. You got a little bit more burp up in there? You got a little bit more burp up in there? Yeah, I can't even think of what the name of them patches is called. But she told me to put on this stuff and then put the patch on. CBC oil is legal in all 50 states. You can get it offline. You can get it offline, or you can go to a smoke shop and get it and buy where I buy mine. And you just put the oil on your body. See, I can't take the risk because I get blood tested from my doctor. My doctor gave me the dissolvable pain pill called Belbuca. Never again. Ill, sick, to what I know. Oh, wow. Right. See, that's what I tell the doctor. I don't need anything new. Let me stick with what works. And, you know, like, after a certain time, the Percocets will probably get immune to my system, but so the dosage will have to be up. They take the TMI out, so the medication benefits of the oil. So you just put the oil on your skin, or you drink it? Because this, y'all is teaching me some stuff. I say that every time we be talking about pain, because people don't understand how, you know, living with chronic pain, it's really, really hard. I mean, it will stop you from living. I mean, really, it will put you back to just existing. Oh, wow. I understand. And welcome, welcome, welcome to the live stream. Girl, I got some stuff I'm going to be sending you. Say hi to your auntie. Hello, Auntie Lynn. Hi. I love you so much. Thank you for everything you send me. I just love it. I found some hats to match my sleepers. Yes. Lynn, every time he puts that blue one on, I be trying to hurry up and snap a picture of it before he goes to messing it up, and bam, he throws up on it so I can't still take the picture. I be like, oh my gosh. But say, I'm going to get a good bath tonight. Yeah, I'm going to get a good bath tonight. Lynn says she loves you. I have a website for the CBD. But Detox Diva, do you drink it? Drink it? Can you message me on Twitter about that? Oh, okay. Okay, okay, okay. What the matter? What the matter with Granny Lexi's baby? Y'all, look at this. Y'all, I just think it's sitting like that? Yeah. You got tired of sitting like that? Ooh, y'all, it's gotten so dark. Look. Let me turn over here so y'all can see. Look how dark it's gotten out there. And it's not even dark time. It's getting ready to storm. Why are you bringing that in here?
What?
All of that. Well, where you find that at?
In my room.
I probably took it in there. I'm vamping and I have a palm to rub on. I put it under the tongue and you can buy lotion or you can buy the roll-on. Just come in many different ways. I have edibles right now. Oh yeah, I vape. It's as well. Oh, so the vape is that thing that you
Shamira has.
Oh, I know. Oh, you put it in there. What are you looking at?
Y'all teaching her something new. Every time she gets on.
I know. Alexa said y'all are teaching her something new. Oh, wow. Wow. Now, does that help you, Leilani, when you vape? He done already had his sessions of throwing up. Wow, y'all. CBD, you don't have to worry about being tested. I have been tested many times with it, and the THC is not in there, so no worries. My husband has two vapes. Oh, really? Wow. You know, that must be what I be seeing those people in the cars be doing.
You remember when we went to Atlantic City and Chris, Shamira's friend, and he that's what he was doing.
Oh, I thought he was smoking cigarettes.
Oh, those cigarettes aren't out that much smoke.
I tell y'all, I be on that yellow bus, honey.
Short bus.
Yellow bus, short bus, green bus. Oh, my gosh. No, I mean, well, it gets me hot, too hot. Oh, really? Wow. See, people don't understand. When you live with chronic pain, you've got to find ways out from other people of what can help with this chronic pain. I've never taken my Nutron. It's over a month since I've started using it. And, you know, I need that Nutron. I've never heard of Nutron. I may even be saying it wrong, but it looks like Nurontin. Nurontin. That sounds like a nerve medication. Oh, girl, just me said, oh, girl, CBT works. I'm telling you, my pain has really eased up, and I have fibromyalgia. Oh, my gosh. You know, people who say they have fibromyalgia, now that's some pain. Mine doesn't get me high at all. Really? Whew. Like, right now, my hands are burning, and let me move you on this side, little nugget. I don't know if y'all can see that vein. Oh, wait. If y'all can see that vein, y'all, excuse my ashy hands. See how green it is? It's activated. So it's disturbed. So it hurts and it burns. It's like even if I put hot water on it, you would think like I touched the stove or something. What the matter? Yeah. You want to talk back to the people? Is that what the problem is? You want to talk back to the people? Yeah. Wow. Look at him smiling at y'all. Y'all, he's seeing himself in two different places. I don't know if he knows that that's him. Do you know that that's you? Do you know that that's you? Oh, I heard it coming. Y'all, you gotta know them sounds, honey. Okay, let me get some more. I want to have, I know! Him so precious. He's so precious. You see yourself? Auntie Linsa, you're so precious. I can't wait to take you to her house. Yeah, I can't wait to take you to her house. I don't think she lived that far. Yes, Shamita, look. All right, y'all, let me have to hold him this way so y'all can get the whole full effect. 8 weeks. 10 weeks. 10 weeks old. Look at them thighs. Say, I'm 10 weeks old. Yeah. I know, Shamita. You see him? You see him, Shamita? Y'all, look. See, he's going to be a big boy. Yes, he is 10 weeks old. Oh, okay. That's not that bad of a ride. That's not that bad of a ride. Once I get some new tires on Miss Journey, because she went to the shop to get an oil change, and they told me she needs 4 new tires. But everything else was fine with her, just the 4 new tires. And they was like, do you want us to do that today? No, she's just here for the oil change. Just do the oil change. You got some more little bubbles? Okay, wait up. Hold on. Let me take this off. Let Granny Lexi take this off. Okay. We got a fresh one right here. Oh, this is a big one. I don't want to use that. Hold on. Hold on. What you laughing at? What are you laughing at? Oh, you talking? Y'all, this is what happens, honey. You got to be prepared because you just don't know what's going to come out. Okay. Is it night-night time? Is it night-night time? Oh, thank you. We look forward to the little ride. Oh, here we go. Okay, let me put my hair back, y'all. Pull your hand out of there. Yeah, well, you need to stay there and get out of mine's. I did. There you go. Casey, since I can't take pain medication and I don't qualify for pain management because I have too much deductible and co-insurance, I do alternative relief. Oh, okay. Well, I'm glad that works for you, Detox Diva, because I thank God that I have medical insurance that covers me because the only thing I don't like about my insurance is if I go in the hospital, my deductible is $750 if they keep me and $75 if they send me home. So that's why I always go to, what you looking at? What you looking at? Yeah. Yeah. What are you talking about? That's why I always go to urgent care through Kaiser because I don't have to pay anything. The copay is free. But, and to me, I don't know. Sometimes I wish I did go to the hospital, to be honest. Like when I had that pneumonia. Yeah, what you talking about? They say, what you talking about? Plug it in, plug it in. That's what we used to say to Alexis because she was truly a pacifier baby. There we go. Yeah. You sound like you pooping. You got me this morning, though. Yeah, you got me real good. Yeah. So I can pretty much get anything, but I don't want them to think that I'm some drug addict or anything like that. So I just try to just manage with what I have. But if that doesn't work, you know, That's when I'll go to my primary care and be like, hey, we got a problem. We need to fix it because ain't nobody got time to keep going back and forth, back and forth. You know, let's get this problem resolved right now. Yeah, I know. You like to choke people. So, you know, I just look forward to, well, not, I don't look forward to getting sick. Because a lot of people were saying I should have been in the hospital when I had pneumonia, not at home recovering. But I was like, because I could have infected everybody and I had strep throat too. But honey, God is so good. God is so good. Where you going? You sound like you doing something. What's that on your neck? Y'all, this is how I have to check, y'all. Is you doing something in there? I learned not to stick my hand in there. I learned that lesson already. You say, no, I'm not doing anything, Granny Lexi. Yeah. Wow, he's a bunker. Wow, he's a bunker. My son was 10 pounds and 9 ounces, and I love big babies. Nicholas says, hey, boss lady. Hey, Nicholas. Alexis, y'all, I think he's like around 11 pounds now. I gotta hold him up again, y'all. I'm gonna stop moving you around. This was the size of Alexis. Alexis was born at 11 pounds and 3.3 ounces. Could you just imagine? Whew, she was a bigums, honey, y'all. She was this size at birth. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I used you like that. Yeah. There we go. Yes, it is. Yeah. Tell me all about it. I know. They say they love that little nugget. Yes, they do, your aunties and uncles. They say they love that little nugget. You are just a chunky baby. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, she was huge. So I said I couldn't wait for him to get this size so that I can use him as an example. He keeps those arms and legs going. Yes, especially these little fat legs. I was like, man, you burning some cardio, honey. Yeah. Yes, she was. I got the headphones on, y'all. That was real. I was sitting here thinking that I was had noise in the background, like the fan was on, and I was just talking through y'all through the headphones. I was wondering why.
I need one.
Yeah.
Two,
I know.
Three, four, five, six, seven. What
is it called? Let me show them the pictures.
How you can show them this one? You can't show them this one because I was looking rusty.
Yeah.
You can show them this one because my hair was on fleek, but they have to find me.
I know it's night time.
Now, so show them this one because this picture makes my skirt now look short. Okay, you can also show them this one because I was also looking cute because my dress is on point. Okay. You can also show them this one because I look absolutely cute and innocent. Yeah. That's the dress when you don't read.
They said how pretty the pictures are of Alexis. Thank you. She said, thank you. Let him go. I know it's time to go night-night. Yeah. Time to go night-night. I know. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. That's it?
Yeah, the rest are already in frames.
Oh, okay. Well, when you get your job, you can go to the dollar store and get your frames. You all, I have to travel to Jacksonville, Florida. I need to see a genetics and a neurologist and a cardiologist. And because they don't have doctors here to help. Oh, wow. How far is that away from you, Casey?
I know that baby's so tired.
Is it not? Yeah, I can feel it moving. Wax.
He might be hungry.
He just ate.
I've been in my room for more than 2 hours. Oh, someone is cooking out at the picnic area.
Oh, they are?
Mm-hmm. That is so ratchet.
What a matter?
Dina has the nerve to have a nice grass, like
there you
the
go.
White House type of grass.
There you go. Let me wipe your little face. Oh, there you
dark.
Go.
No, honey.
Them headphones, man. Get your ears itching.
They do not.
Stand on your face. I got it, whatever it was. Yeah. Oh, you can grill here at the picnic area. But I don't think I would want to grill outside. That's why I have an indoor grill that you can just put right on top of the stove. I bought it from when I got the little purple thing for my kitchen. Yeah. You need your little nose clean. Oh, got it. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. It's all right. It's all right. Yes, you're okay. I want to thank everybody for thumbsing up the video today. I really, really, really appreciate it. I feel blessed and honored. We have 31 thumbs up, you all. I am so, so, so excited and happy about that. So, if you haven't thumbsed up this video already, please, just takes just but a second, and it's free. You just hit it and keep on watching and keep on talking. Yeah, I know. Say, we like thumbs up. Yes, we do. Say, we love them. Yes, we do. I know. Look at that smile. Look at that smile. Yes. So, for the rest of the evening, Shamira should be here probably within the next hour or so. So, I'll probably take these pictures and put this stuff up on my Poshmark. Everything is probably going to sell for like $5. I don't, it's nothing, you know, extravagant, I should say. But I am going to go in the kitchen tonight and, you know, cook that teriyaki beef. I have it in the refrigerator now, marinating, and I put the meat tenderizer on there so that the beef could, because she bought the wrong beef. She bought like beef stew beef. So what I did was I cut them as many times as I could to thin them out and washed them really good. And then I put some meat tenderizer on it so that it can help to tenderize the meat. James Caldwell, Falwell, Basketball Wives Review. Did y'all watch Basketball Wives and Love and Hip Hop last night? Y'all, I know this is crazy, but I love me some ratchet TV, okay? I really love Love and Hip Hop. I really loved when Bad Girls Club came on. Those were things that also helped get me through my depression, to be honest with you. Because it was teaching me to not let people... y'all, he's got the weave. And he's very strong. He's pulling it. Can I have it back? Thank you. It really helped me to learn how to, you know, put people in their place the right way. Okay, Boss Lady Lexi, see you next time. Have a blessed night. Thank you so much. I don't want any of that mess. My husband pulls me away 2 years ago and haven't looked back. Really? Thank you so much, Tamika. Thank you. Oh, I knew I felt some warmness on me. Yeah, you threw up on my Granny Lexi's arm. Yeah, you did. Y'all, I swear, I think it's this milk that's really hurting his. Oh, it's on my dress too, all over the place. Granny Lexi's gonna have to change her clothes. I really think he's allergic to milk, but this doctor, she keeps saying, laugh out loud, that voice change. Yeah, he's got the weave. Yes, honey, he had it, Leilani. What was I going to say? I really think he has milk allergy. I really do, because I understand babies do throw up from their milk, but not this much. And as y'all can see, he's done thrown up at least 3 to 4 times. And that's why he probably be so hungry, you know, with before the 2 hours, because he throws up so much of the food. Well, so much of his liquid. And every time before he throws up, he gets a little cranky. And that's how I know, or I can hear it coming up.
Yeah, I know.
And look, y'all, he just holds his little head up on his own. 10 weeks, it's something in this formula. No, throwing up constantly is a dead giveaway. It is, he may have reflux. He does have reflux, but I feel like if they give him a better formula, that formula can help with the reflux, because the Zantac is definitely not working.
Yeah, the Zantac is not working for me.
Look at this. Look at him. We need a diaper change too. Yeah. He is so strong. He is very, very, very strong. What is that? The towels? So those have to go in next. Well, we can at least wash him tonight and just let him sit in the washing machine. I said he threw up. It was all on my arm and my clothes.
It was on his feet. No, it was on your thigh.
Oh. There we go.
It's still on your leg.
Y'all, he is a mess. Do y'all hear me? The doctor had to switch my twins' milk 3 times. What did she switch them to, Shamita? I had to feed Ryan with her body right up and keep her right up for at least 20. Right. We do that too. And, y'all, it just doesn't matter what it is. Even trying to not move him around. She did. She had put him on one medicine. I mean, one formula one time. And what you say?
I didn't say nothing. I'm talking to Baby Nugget.
Oh, she put him on one formula one time, but she only gave one can to test him on. So that one can wasn't enough, but he still threw up. But I was looking online, and I see that Similac has a whole lot of
he can drink my milk.
Different formulas that babies can take for colic and, right. Nutramigen is supposed to be really, really good for babies with acid reflux. So I'm going to tell Shamira when she goes back to take him to the doctors again to please make sure that you stress that.
He's pooping.
No, he's not. He's been making that noise for a while. I'm going to tell her to make sure that she stresses that they change his formula, or she's going to take him to another doctor. And I'm sure that doctor does not want to... That doctor does not want to lose a patient.
Say team, Dr. Decor.
Team. Hey, Eric. Aaron, how are you? Goat's milk was great. You know, that's what we grew up on. We grew up on pet milk.
On who milk?
Pet milk. It was carnation milk, and you just mix it with some water and some Karo syrup.
Some who syrup?
Karo syrup.
Who is that?
See, they don't know about that stuff we grew up on. And I wish I could make him some good old home.
I'm so glad I'm lactose intolerant.
Some home milk like that. But see, I really think that, you know, he's allergic to milk. That's just my own personal opinion. Just from the experience that I had from Alexis being allergic to milk. Because this projectile vomiting and stuff is... Shamarin, I've been... She now knows when she comes in, she takes her shirt completely off.
Like in the middle of the night. That's the flu.
And not only that, in the middle of the night, it just flies across the room. He throws up. If you're trying to give him a kiss or something like that, you better know better, because if you don't, it's going to be all over you. And it's going to be in your mouth. It's going to be everywhere. So you've just got to be with him. And Alexis, too. I remember she threw up all over the church. I had to clean it up. I was so mad. But she was an infant like him. She didn't know no better. So I told Shamira, you're going to have to make this little lady listen. And if she don't listen, tell her you want a second opinion. You want to take him to a specialist to, you know, really, really make sure, because I know as an adult, if we constantly throw up and throw up and throw up, we feel that acid in our throat days later, and you think you get indigestion and all of that, and you go into the hospital thinking that you're having a heart attack and all of that stuff, and it's just from too much of that acid coming back up from out of your stomach. So imagine what a baby is going through, and you know, he can't tell you or talk and say, this is what's happening to me. You as the parent have to be the advocate for that child and speak on that child's behalf. I remember Ryan just spewed straight down my back from the shoulder to the foot. And I, yes, that happened to me a lot. Oh, man, he can't take pet milk, those ages. Right, exactly. That's why I said he has to. I mean, and he can go maybe 2 hours, but it's normally like an hour and a half for the next feeding, because he just throws up so much. It's dirty. That's why I throw it in the floor. That's dirty clothes in the floor.
No, it was trash.
Yeah, so it's a lot. That's why I say it is so much. It's a lot with babies. You've got to really, really know what you're doing.
That baby's so cute.
Yeah, he's very cute.
No, he's
You've got to really, really know what you're doing when it comes to these babies, man. We've got to really, really speak for them. Yes. But, y'all, I'm going to get off here and sweep my floor. Get everything together, pull out this vacuum cleaner and try to vacuum a little bit. I'm glad we don't have carpet, that everything is hardwood floors. No, my rug right there. She thought I was going to vacuum the hardwood floors, y'all.
We don't have one of those.
I don't know. Is there a vacuum cleaner that vacuum hardwood floors?
Yes. I think it's
Swifter. Oh, I don't know, y'all. I just know about the regular
oil.
The regular old vacuum. But anyway, y'all, I want to thank you all so much for tuning in today to Taco Tuesdays Live with Boss Lady Lexi and Little Nugget. Today is Tuesday, isn't it?
We're not eating tacos.
I know, but it's Tuesday. It's called Taco Tuesday. I would like to thank you all for tuning in and staying with me so long. I really appreciate you all. I love you all equally. He's throwing up. I love you all equally. I appreciate you all so much. I just love you all so much. And if you are not a part of the Little Bosses Squad, don't forget to hit that red button. Hit the bell that's right next to it to be notified of the next upload. And don't forget to leave a positive comment in the comment section. As you all know, it's always hashtag 1 pound at a time. Hashtag 1 pound at a time. It's my journey, my weight loss journey. I can do it on my journey. 1 pound at a time. 1 pound at a time. Hashtag 1 pound at a time. Hashtag 1 pound at a time. Bye, my little bosses. Enjoy your evening with your loved ones and have a great night. See you in the next video.